Half Alive is an incredible band that has a lot to say. The messages of all three of their songs so far have been incredibly deep, and so when I heard that they were putting out a new single, Arrow, and there was a music video, I was pretty sure that I was probably going to explain it. And so I took a look at the music video, I read the lyrics, and I think I cracked the code. I think I know what is up with this song. Let me explain. Hey everybody, I'm Clifford Stumpy, the Pop Song Professor, and welcome to my channel where we make English class awesome by explaining and sometimes roasting song lyrics on school days. And today we're talking about Arrow by Half Alive, their new single that is fantastic. You probably recognize Half Alive from the music video where they were doing the super intricate choreography in that weird basement room with all the lights in the ceilings that like all sorts of music videos use. To be fair, they used it best. Well, they put out another music video, and this one has a lot of like retro 70s vibes with the decor and the clothing that people are wearing, stuff like that. And these lyrics are no less deep than the lyrics in previous songs that we've heard. Check this out in the first verse. Life begins to happen when I plan something else. Trying to be somebody, but all I got was someone else. My plan's always changing, always rearranging. No. Slow it down, release control, slow and steady, let me know. First off, these lyrics are really well written. The sound correlation is subtle, but it's there strongly, and the whole thing is just very eloquently put. But the meaning of this is pretty interesting. So, life begins to happen when I plan something. This song, Arrow, is all about him wanting to be somewhere, wanting to get somewhere, wanting success, but he's not quite there yet, but things are still better than they were before. The song, Arrow, is really about being kind of in the middle between the beginning of possible success and then one day actually achieving success, which is where the band is at. Trying to be somebody but all I got was someone else means that probably things didn't go quite exactly to plan. He got something good, but it wasn't what he was expecting. And by he, I mean Josh Taylor, the lead singer slash songwriter for the band. He comes to this conclusion at the end of the verse where he says, slow it down, release control, slow and steady, let me know, where he basically is saying, you know what? I'm not gonna push at this too hard. I'm gonna let whatever happens happen. Just let me know where we end up. The chorus is probably the most telling. We hear the hardest place to be is right where you are. I mean, that makes a lot of sense. Cause yeah, you look back at the past and you say, yeah, I made it, it was okay. You look at the future and you're like, oh, I'm gonna be rich or famous or whatever one day. But in the present, you're like, nope, this kind of sucks and I can't wait for what comes next. Or, you know, it was better back then. The hardest place to be is right where you are. Then he continues, in the space between the finish and the start, which could be an analogy for the band, but it could also be an analogy for life in general. He finishes, it's the arrow in your heart, the arrow in your heart. Now, why is this hard place to be an arrow in your heart? The song doesn't fully explain, but it's the metaphor that he's going with. Perhaps because it's something that seems to have happened to you and it is causing you a great amount of pain at a vital point. Yep, that's the best I can do. Verse 2, he gets even more explicit with the message of the song. Now I'm restless, running from the present. I know my mind's been cheating, thinking that I will arrive, get famous, make all the money, sell the songs. But my plan's always changing, always rearranging, etc., etc. Now, to be fair, the song is not just probably about songwriting for him. It probably could apply to a lot of different things in his life, just as it can apply to a lot of different things in our lives. In the bridge we hear, I'm fast out and I'm exhausted, out of breath, thinking where I went wrong. This heart is afraid to beat slowly. I need to take advantage of the place that I'm in. You know, and maybe if this does apply to the band's success, you know, we had Still Feel go really big, like, oh my gosh, we gotta do something to follow that up or we're gonna miss our chance. He says, miss a chance at what I could become. I know that I can't run forever, but I can't stand still for too long. This heart is afraid to beat slowly. By the way, if you have an arrow in your heart and your heart starts beating faster, you're gonna lose a lot more blood. I don't know if that's part of the metaphor, but it could be. We see the same message mirrored in the music video where the guys are sitting at the table, they look at the fridge, it's got this message in dry erase marker that says, the rest of your life. It's like if you open up the fridge, you'll get to know what the rest of your life is like. One of the band members goes over, erases it with his arm, and they just start playing music, which seems to be a really good metaphor for a healthy way to deal with fear of the future. Eh, forget about it, let's just have fun right now. A similar thing happens in the living room scene where the TV says the rest of your life, and they're like, eh, whatever, they get up, they turn it off, and they play some more music. At one point, we see Josh Taylor go to the kitchen, open up the fridge, and stare at this like green light that's coming out of the fridge. We don't see what the rest of his life looks like, but at one point, he kind of gets tired of it too. He's like, yeah, this isn't such a good idea. he goes and like becomes a goth and they start playing music some more. I'm not really sure what the goth part means. It would seem too simplistic for him to be saying that, oh, if you know the rest of your life, you're gonna become depressed. Maybe it's a commentary on his means of coping with stress. But the big point is that they keep playing music in the moment and the fridge door gets closed. So overall, Arrow has a deep meaning about wanting to not spend too much time being afraid or excited for the future even. Let's just enjoy the moment where we're at and let's do this moment really well, rather than constantly living in either the future or the past. It's probably a pretty good lesson for all of us to learn, even though, you know, we have to do things like planning and remembering. But remember that happiness isn't found tomorrow or yesterday, it's found today. Something that I do a terrible job in my personal life of actually following. But anyways, guys, that's Arrow by Half Alive. Is there a Half Alive song that I should explain next? Comment it down below. And if you want to be a songwriter yourself, check out the magical songwriting process in the description down below. You'll become amazing or something. Cool. Check out these videos right here. Thanks for watching, and I'll talk to you guys next time.